that song's never been played in this church. We good? All right. Well, this is the second half. Won't be as long as the first. It's a little more chill, a little more hangout. We're just going to do some music and just hang out. Is that cool? Good at that? Right on. I'm going to do a quick, I have a friend here tonight, I think. Charmin, are you here? Charmin, where are you at? I want to have a wedding gift for you. Are you here? What's that? Turn on the air condition? Yeah, that'd be great. I don't, maybe didn't pay the bill. I don't know. But is Charmin here? Charmin, are you here? Raise your hand or you gotta make noise. I don't even know if she's here. She might. Okay. Don't say the squeeze the Charmin bit. I get that. I know that. But anyway, I thought she was gonna be here tonight. Anyway, well, this half is, I don't know, let's just get it going then. Sorry, nice try. I don't know. Sometimes it, maybe she's in prison. I don't know. But anyway, let's do a quick one. I'll just a couple songs been working on. That. This is a song called Getting Out of Prison. Two, three, four. I apologize for that. I'm just as disappointed as you are. That is, that's just stupid. You know, I don't have, believe it or not, I don't have songs for every occasion, right? I get booked at gigs. I don't know. I got booked at a Jehovah's Witness church one time. And believe it or not, I don't have a Jehovah's Witness song. And he wanted me to write one, so I did. I'll do a little bit of it for you right now. Two, three, four. You might want to leave now. It's not going to get any better. But see, music is magical, yo, because, you know, through music, I can tell who in here watched television in the 90s. I can't. How about that? So no one told you that was going to be this way. Isn't that pathetic right there? You forget your kids' names, but you know when to clap for the friend song. But see, that's the thing. Our brain remembers these things we really don't need. But we do remember, you know, we forget things we do need. And it beep, 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 boop. See, there's jingles in our head that's going to be there forever. There's not, you can't get them out. Let me prove this to you. We'll do a little test, all right? You finish these jingles for me. Like if I said, Frosted Lucky Charms. One for one. Liberty, liberty, liberty. Two for two. 800-588-2300. Oh, you losers. You're like harmonizing. Empire. For a great low rate, you can get online. What? Ephesians 8:11. Oh, shame, shame, shame. You know, it's really sad. There is no Ephesians 8:11, I tell you. Right? And people are like, you know, Tim, there's the pandemic and everything. 2 years of pandemic. Are you going to write any pandemic songs? I'm like, you don't have to write pandemic songs, man. Just use the ones that are already there. Work for the pandemic. Like, if you die.
Don't stand so close to me.
You could do that one. Oh, what the?
Don't cough around here no more. Don't cough around here no more.
Come on, Eileen, I've got COVID-19. At this moment, I can't taste anything. You could do that. You do that one. How about?
I got a little change in my pocket going jing-a-ling-a-ling.
Call you on telephone, baby, but you're quarantined. And each tap of towel, I get the same old thing. I wait no huggy-duggies until I get the vaccine. My honey, my baby, those needles give me an ouchie. She said 6 feet away and listen to Dr. Fauci.
What? Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my goodness. Where's that guy been? Do you miss him? Every day, like,
well, the thing is the deal. Today,
probably the best thing to do. Now, this is not really difficult. Because we just don't know. And what you should do today, maybe, it could change in an hour. But I'm saying now. Because the droplets are flying and the data's out and the numbers are coming in. Why? We got our best people thinking about it now. Of course, I consult my papier-mâché clown I keep on a chair by my bed. But right now, probably the best thing to do today is 14 masks on your face. And a bag over your head. Take a brick and pound yourself in the skull until you pass out. Probably the best thing you can do. Maybe. Maybe. But really, if you want to really know what I think about it, you should probably just sit on the pot. Probably sit on.
I did write a pandemic joke. I'll do it for you. What do you get when you cross ivermectin and hydrochloroquine? You get better. I don't know. I don't know. It's all about options. All right. Let's get serious here just for a second. I don't want to pass up this opportunity. It is all about being healthy, ladies and gentlemen. And I want to, you know, I just have a responsibility to help when I can, and that's why this next song is more of a PSA, public service announcement. People, you get older, it's nothing to be ashamed of. Take care of yourself, you know what I'm saying? That's what this song is about, and if this song helps one person here tonight, then to me, it's all worth it. You have some lovely children and a lovely wife. You had a healthy bank account and have a healthy life. But you knew the day was coming, was always meant to be. The doctor says it's time to have a colonoscopy. Oh, colonoscopy. A wonderful procedure, as everyone can see. Your number's up, it's time to take one for the team. It's right there on the schedule, a colonoscopy. There is some preparation that you should know about. You have to drink this fluid that will surely clean you out. They take a certain instrument to look around inside. And honestly, I'll tell you, it can be a bumpy ride. Oh, colonoscopies. A wonderful procedure to help prevent disease. Stay close to a bathroom and careful when you sneeze. You can't get away from colonoscopy. It's not a lot of pleasure, it's not a lot of fun, but now you're turning 40, so you know it must be done. It's not an ordinary, typical exam. You lay down on the table and then, thank you, ma'am. Oh, colonoscopy. A wonderful procedure, I'm sure you will agree. And never underestimate how thorough they will be. It's time to take your medicine, colonoscopy. You know, one thing the pandemic taught me was that I have the most non-essential job there is. That hurts a little bit. You laughed a lot there. But I was not always a comedian before. As a comic, I did lots of things. I was waited tables. I was a substitute teacher. Did computer support. Rented cars. I did singing mammograms. That was the most awkward job I've ever had in my life. What do you sing? The hills are alive. I didn't know what to sing. I was in some Christian heavy metal bands, Guns N' Moses, Twisted Scripture, Def Shepherd, Prairo Smith, ACJC, and Ozzy Osbourne again, just a few. Oh no, I was not allowed to listen to Ozzy Osbourne or that kind of stuff when I was a kid. You know why? Because my mom found out that in metal records they put secret messages. If you played a record backwards, you'd hear an evil message. Some of you did that, you remember that? Take a metal record into your room, lock the door, turn off the light. Play it backwards. While Satan wants a hot dog. So funny, I saw an interview with Ozzy Osbourne years later, and this lady asked him, Ozzy, did you put secret messages in your records backwards? Right? Should have played the interview backward. All right, I'm going to do a song. This is a brand new song, and it's kind of a love song. And if you've done some traveling on this part of the country, you may know. I'm just going to do it. Some of you will get this, and some of you may not. And if you get it, you're really going to get it. So here, let's just do it. Well, I don't know if we really landed people on the moon. Now I'm not sure if Lady Gaga uses auto-tune. And I'm uncertain there'll be peace over in the Middle East. But I just saw a big sign, honey, and one thing is true. I do know we'll be stopping at Bucky's. Time to have some fun. It's like a gas station, car wash, barbecue, Cracker Barrel, Walmart, all in one. Driving these wide open spaces, now I need a redneck oasis. Take my money, bucket baby, here's my lucky day. I polish off some beaver nuggets, try a little fudge, jerky and a pulled pork sandwich just because. I get a leather bolo and a hoodie for the wife, cast iron frying pan, taffy and a knife. Get some roasted pecans, a chewy for the dogs, positive encouragement painted on a log, a large banana pudding, Cali chicken wrap, coffee for the journey, and a Bucky Beaver cap. I do know we'll be stopping at Bucky's, it's my ritual. My stomach's growling, my gas tank's empty, and my bladder's full. Hanging with the unwashed masses, Bible verses on shot glasses. Take my money, bucket, baby, cinnamon roll and a homemade gravy. Take my money, bucket, honey, it's my lucky day. Yes, it is. All right, that's good. You mind if I go to the piano real quick? That cool? All right. Give me just a second here. All right. It's probably the best thing to do. What's going on? Am I in trouble?
Hi, Lord. How am I doing so far? That's a song called The Year 2020. That's all I know of that song right there. All right, get your lighters out. Let's make a memory right now. Let's do an oldie. Get those lighters out, yeah. Let's make a memory. If you know it, sing it along. Chick-fil-A. I could eat there 7 times a day. Where the people laugh and children play. Oh, I'm in love with Chick-fil-A. Yeah. If you're from South Carolina, get the real lighters out. Suddenly, I need waffle fries in front of me with some nuggets and a large sweet tea. Oh, Chick-fil-A, you set me free. Kids, get in the van so we can go there today. But their stores are closed, though I know, 'cause it's... Has that happened to you too? And you're like, Chick-fil-A! What a dirty, rotten trick to play. Now we have to settle for Subway. Oh, I'm in love with Chick-fil-A. Sing it with me. Chick-fil-A. Here's a story. Years ago, I was sitting on the bus, back of the bus, and the wheels on the bus go round and round. Oh, yeah, they do, they go. And I was writing this song, and I was like, this is the dumbest song I've ever written. No one will ever want to hear it. And now, some people get angry when I don't perform it. So this is for you, and you know who you are. My wife was out for 3 days to visit her mom. I was supposed to cook and clean while she was gone. Somehow she never buckles under all the demands.
I had to know her secret and I had to understand. Well, I thought it might be coffee, but that gives her the shakes. Might be soap operas, she says they're too fake. It's not the car she drives, what she puts in her hair. Yeah, it's gotta be something that she wears. That's right, yoga pants. She wears them all day, yoga pants. The clapping's throwing me off a little bit. At work at the play, yoga pants. What's all the fuss? What makes them so special that they keep them from us? Yoga pants. Well, any normal person would leave it alone, but I'm not a normal person and nobody was home. Don't get ahead of me. My wife was out of town and the kids were outside, so I went into the bedroom and decided I would try her yoga pants. Stretchy and thin, these yoga pants. Feels like my own skin, yoga pants. Where you been all my life? I've never done yoga, but these make me wanna try yoga pants. Soft and so sleek, yoga pants. Feels good on my cheeks, yoga pants. I'll just say thanks. I don't wear yoga pants. I wear Spanx. Oh, yoga pants, all love those yoga pants. Creepiest song ever written right there. Oh my God. Feeling the love in the air tonight. Somebody should, I love you too, creepy lady. You never call me. Got some people on date night here tonight. That's awesome. Anybody here engaged to be married? Really? Oh my gosh. Okay. Who? Really? What are your names? Not only she takes your surname, she takes my name too. We're just Kyle now. Kyle. He's like, I got it for me, honey. You're on your own. Kyle! You go in a restaurant, table for Kyle, and whatever she wants to do. Kyle and who? And who, Natalie? Adley? Hadley? Hadley? Kyle and Hadley. That was easy. Kyle and Hadley, well, I can feel the glow right now from you two right now. The love is strong with you two. Super strong. Kyle, you're in for a whirlwind of a life. Because marriage is awesome, and it really is. It changes, but it's always good, and it's always you're growing together and loving one another. And I love marriage. Marriage is very beneficial because, Kyle, when you get married now, you have a little helper in the car. Yeah, you get a little helper in the car, and I love my helper. She's very helpful because she knows everything about driving, and I don't know how I get anywhere without my little helper in the car. She helps me in lots of ways. Like she tells me when the light changes color and that's too long for her. She just tells me when it happens because I get confused sometimes the colors when they change like that. It's like, it's green. Okay, thank you. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to do, little helper. Thank you. I always know how fast I'm going with my helper in the car. She lets me know how fast. You know how fast you're going? Yeah, I got a little speedometer telling me how fast. That little red stick breaks in half. I got you to back me up. I love my little helper. She's so helpful. When we're in a different town and I do something weird in the car, she lets me know. She's like, you need to be careful. You don't know these roads. I'm like, I know, because they're different than the roads we have at our house.
They have left turns here. I don't know what I'm supposed to do up there. Maybe I should grab the magic circle and turn it. They do things weird here in North Carolina with turns and stuff, so thank you for your help.
But Kyle, Hadley, I'm telling you, it's good, but you need to go to counseling. That's not a joke. Go to counseling. It's just maintenance for your marriage, okay? Because you learn a lot of things about yourself in counseling. And sometimes it's kind of painful, but it's good. It helps you grow. Like, counseling taught me that I don't have a lot of empathy. I mean, I don't care what you people think about it. I remember our first marriage counseling session, Kyle. I was just sitting there, and my wife and the counselor were just going back and forth for like 2 hours, and I was just going like this the whole time. And finally, the counselor looks at me, and he goes, "You're a narcissist." Finally, we're talking about me. My little helper was upset. She goes, "What does that mean?" I'm like, "Honey, it's no big deal. It just means we're in love with the same man." And people ask me about that, about my wife. They're like, "Tim, what does your wife think about you talking about her on stage?" And I'm like, "You got to understand one thing. My wife's love language is cha-ching." Right? She's like, "Bring home a check, funny boy. I don't care what you say, just bring it home. I need new wood floors, okay? Do whatever you have to do to make that happen." Kyle and Hadley, it's good. Though marriage is good. And that first year of marriage, marriage is a roller coaster, okay? And that first year, it's really exciting, you know? You're on that first hill. You're just going up, right? It's really, really exciting, you know? You got your Coke and your teddy bear, and you're just on that first hill, and you're just, "Oh, this is going to be great." This is awesome. Buckle up, buttercup. That's all I'm saying. Because your life will change in many interesting ways. Then you're probably going to have kids. That's going to be a lot of fun. You're not going to have a lot of money to work with, you know? You're going to try to save money, but it'll never work. One time I bought my kids a $5 slip and slide. Got an $800 water bill. In counseling, you also learn, Kyle and Hadley, that you should ask questions. If you get into a fight, start asking questions. Don't just spew out what you think. Ask questions, right? You want her to be heard, right? And we all ask dumb questions as married people, don't we, of one another? We all do it, right? One time I came home, my wife was like, "Where were you?" I go, "I stopped by McDonald's on the way home." She goes, "Why?" I don't know, they had a petting zoo? Why else would I stop by McDonald's? But I do the same thing. She called me one day. She goes, "I'm lost." I go, "Where are you?" She said, "I don't want to be married to you anymore." But you're going to laugh so much, Kyle and Hadley. You're going to laugh so much. And you just got to be in the moment. Because you can't write the truth. You can't. You're going to love it. Remember one time my kids were out of the house. My wife were home. We had a date night at home. No kids. We were just sitting on the couch. She was on her iPad. I was reading a book. And I farted. I did. I farted. And she goes, "What?" It's like, "What do you mean, what? I didn't say anything, I just farted." I couldn't sleep that night. I was thinking about it. That could only mean two things.
Either her hearing is going bad, or that's what I sound like to my wife when I talk. How long's that been going on? You take this woman to be your wife?
Like, honey, what do you want to eat tonight?
I love Mexican. Let's do that. That's a good idea. So Kyle Hadley, this is a special night for a lot of people here, some birthdays and stuff, but I want you guys to remember this night forever. So I just want to do a little song for you. Right now. Kyle and Hadley sitting in a tree. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes marriage, then comes baby in the baby carriage. And if it doesn't happen in that order, you're sinners.
Okay. Oh my God. That was the Baptist version of that song, Kyle. But time goes by so fast, doesn't it? Doesn't it go fast? Man, we have things now we used to not have. You guys remember when there was no Google? Kids, you don't believe me. There was a time in ancient times long ago where there was no Google. I call it the BG period. Before Google. You guys remember before Google and you didn't know something? You just kept on not knowing it. You remember that? You just continued not knowing the answer. Like before Google, you remember you hear a song on the radio and you weren't really sure what the guy was singing, but there was no Google to check the lyrics. So you just had to sing it how it sounded to you. Some of you are thinking of a song right now. So you convinced yourself, this has got to be what he's singing. So you sang that song year after year with more confidence and volume in front of friends and family. They loved you too much to tell you were a moron. Then one day Google comes along, you're like, you know what, I'm gonna Google the lyrics to that song. So you Google the lyrics and you're like, man, I wouldn't close. A song like that for me in the 70s is a song called Rocket Man by Elton John. Remember Rocket Man? And I Google the lyrics and the chorus of Rocket Man, he's actually singing, Rocket Man burning out his fuse up here alone. I never sang it like that. I sang it like this. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. The touchdown brings me round again to find not the man they think I am at home. No. I'm a rocket man. Rocket man. $30 feet on cable gone. $30 feet on and alone. Bernie doesn't feel like cantaloupe. Really? Bernie doesn't feel like cantaloupe. That's what the astronauts are singing. That makes a lot of sense. There's lots of songs growing up I didn't know. Like, anybody remember Eddie Money? In the 70s, Eddie Money had a song called Two Tickets to Paradise. I could have swore he was singing Two Chickens to Paralyze. And there's no Google. That's what I heard. Two Chickens to Paralyze. I think we have a clip. Play that clip, Tim. See what they think. Waiting alone. I've got two tickets to paradise. Like, what kind of farming is going down at the Eddie Money Ranch? This freak is paralyzing chickens down there. Speaking of chickens, you remember that Beatles song? I thought they were singing, She's Got a Chicken to Ride. Is that a ticket to ride? She's got a chicken to ride. I don't know, can you play that? Let's see what. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. And she don't care. How entitled are you? You've got a perfectly good, unparalyzed chicken and you don't wanna, and you don't care. Carrie Underwood has a song I couldn't figure out, Before He Cheats. Have you heard that, Before He Cheats? Isn't that a sweet little ditty? That's the most horrifying song I've ever heard. How does she get away with her? Songs are so violent. She throws you off. She'll do a song about Jesus and baptism.
Then she'd do a song like, well, my boyfriend made fun of my clothes, so I pushed him off the cliff and watched him fall.
Okay, that's a felony, hon. You can't do that. Break up with him. Don't push him off a cliff. You guys know that song, right? Sing with me.
Well, I dug my key into the side of his pretty little souped up four-wheel drive. Carved my name into his letters.
You need to chill out, Chucky. That's what you need to do.
But the next line of that song, it sounds like to me she's singing, I took a Louisville Slugger to both her thighs. That's what I hear, both her thighs. Timmy, play that. Let's see what they think she's saying.
Jesus, you need to let go of the wheel and smack some sense into this woman, I tell you. She needs to go to prison. I don't trust her. I don't think she's human. She doesn't look like a human. All her teeth are the same size. Have you seen Carrie Underwood's teeth? Each tooth is the same tooth. Google her teeth right now. It's amazing. It's like a line of mini marshmallows across the front of her face. Oh, the best one, though, is Louis Armstrong. Remember Louis Armstrong? He had that song, What a Wonderful World. Remember that?
Yeah.
What a wonderful world. I see trees of green, red roses too, magic and blue. Think he needs to sit on the pot.
But there's a line there where he's singing the dark sacred night. I always thought he was singing the dogs say goodnight, which is a better lyric when you think about it, right? That would be a more wonderful world, wouldn't it? If your dogs say goodnight to you. Wouldn't that be wonderful? Like, good night, Skippy.
Good night. I love you, Master. You're the man. I love you. Yeah, thanks for throwing the ball around today. It was fun. And the water and the food. I really appreciate it, man. You're the man. Yeah, you going to bed. I'm going to lick myself for half an hour. I have not been down there in a while. It's a mess between my legs. I don't know what's what, to be honest with you. What? Is that a gummy bear? I don't even know what that is.
I'm hearing some of this for the first time, too. I'm sorry. But the dogs say goodnight. I think we have one more clip. Tim, can you play that? Let's just see. I'm telling you.
Skies are blue and clouds are white. The bright, blessed day. The dogs say goodnight.
Yes, Louis, that would be a wonderful world. A world where the dogs say goodnight, and the cats say good morning, and the chickens are all paralyzed.
How much longer is he gonna do this?
I did not pay money to watch this moron jerk his head from right to left. He is the most non-essential man I've ever heard in my life. You know, it's real funny about that. People in the middle and to my left, you're like, they got four like over there. We only got one. That's totally unfair. You babies. All right. Balcony. There we go. Four, 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 and four. Feels good, doesn't it? It's all balanced. But you know what? I'm going to give them one more over there. because it's going to drive you OCD people crazy. And there's not a thing you can do about it, Newbern. There's not a single thing you can do about it. Unless Will Smith comes up here and knocks this mic out of my hand. They're going to get 5, and you're only going to have 4. And that's just the way it's going to be forever.
And you're like, Tim, why would you do that? Why? That is so mean. I thought I knew you. You've changed. You're crotchety, and you're weird and cringy now. Why would you ever do something like that? I thought you were a Christian. A Christian would never do that.
Yes, I would. And it's coming any second now.
Can you feel the tension in the room right now?
Somebody's head's about to explode over here. All right, there we go.
Well, did you have a good time tonight? You glad you came?
I'm telling you, and I know that some of you did not want to come tonight. I get it. I understand that. You were drugged here against your will. I see your faces. You're like, oh, great, Christian comedian. When's he going to bring out the puppets?
I'm kidding. The homeschoolers are like, yes, a puppet show!
Let's go!
But here's the thing. I'm not a witty guy. I just live my life, take notes, and tell strangers. You could do this. If I can do this, you could do comedy. You can. The only difference between me and you is I have a microphone. And talent. That's the only thing that separate me and you common people. That's it. You stay humble, you know? But I'm not witty, and I think that the world system now is about tearing us apart and telling us how different we are. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, man. And I think we have so much alike. That's what comedy is. Comedy didn't come from me being witty. It's just, I think that some people relate to what I'm talking about. You've had these experiences, haven't you? And it's just like, it's almost like a holy thing, you know, that we're joined in our everyday things that happen to us. Like, you ever been in the bathroom and you're sitting on the pot and you're watching YouTube videos on your phone and you've been in there for a while and you know that because you've lost the feeling in your legs and your legs are numb and your feet are kind of tingly. You got those pink circles on top of your thighs. I call those TikTok circles. You're like, man, I've been wasting time in here, but it's called a stall. It's not like you're a hypocrite. But I was watching this YouTube video, and this English atheist was debating this Christian. They were talking about the existence of God. This posh English atheist was like, you Christians have no proof of God. There's no evidence of God. You have no burden of proof on you Christians. You have no proof of God. You have no proof of God. I think he was a vampire. But I'm here to tell you, if you're here tonight, if you're an atheist, you're welcome. If you're an atheist or Jehovah-phobe, whatever you call yourself, that's a word I just made up. If you're an atheist, you're very welcome here tonight. But I'm here to tell you, if you're here and you believe in a creator, don't be ashamed by that. Don't be embarrassed by that, man. We got proof, baby. I mean, I don't know. And I don't know why we go through things. I really don't. I can't explain it. But I do believe this. When we get to heaven, the word that's going to be used the most is, oh. She's going to get up there like, oh, right? You got lots of proof for God. Man, existence itself. At one point, there was nothing, folks, and now there's this. Nothing. And now there's this. Light and the stars and planets and the earth and systems and gravity, right? And the human body. That just kind of happened, really. Blood clotting, that just kind of evolved. Was there life
before where there was no blood clotting? Wouldn't that stink? Cut your finger. You're like, I guess that's it. It's been a good run. And when did eyelids come about? Was there life before eyelids? People walking around, looking surprised all the time. You need proof of God. People, you have a computer in your head that's made out of meat. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. But I know they're trying to divide us. And I'm just saying, I don't. They're even trying to divide us by the way we eat. Do you know that? I read this article. It's the dumbest thing. It said there's three types of people. You can tell who you are by how you eat your food. Like they said, the first group of people is somebody who, people who like to, their food to touch, all their food to touch. I love that. I love my food to touch. Anybody in here like your food to touch? Anybody? Okay. Now, this article said that if you're that person, that you're more entrepreneurial, you're type A, you like to take risks, you're a visionary, you like to make it happen, you're a self-starter. You know what I'm saying? You're kind of a leader, kind of a person. Next type of person was somebody, sometimes you want your food to touch. Sometimes. Anybody here, sometimes you like your food? Okay. That means you're more managerial, type B. You like task lists. You like to get it done. You're the person who's dependable, reliable. If something needs to get done, you're the person we call. Third type of person was somebody you never like your food to touch at all. Anybody here never like your food to touch at all? Okay. That means you're a racist. Hallelujah. Isn't that fun to learn about yourself, though? And what's really cool is that third group of people, we know exactly who you are now. Because you raise your hands and you scream. Might want to be careful when you go out to your car after the show. But it's been so fun, and I'm really blessed you guys paid the gas money to come here, and I just... Yeah, the world is crazy, and I wish the world went the way I wanted it to. And that's what this last song is about. If the world went the way I wanted it to go, this is what it would be like. Imagine there's no traffic, no construction zone. No driving slow in the fast lane, while texting on smartphones. Imagine all the people driving like they had a brain. Wait for me, baby birds. Imagine kids not whining, no screaming fits or squeals, when they don't get the toy they want in their happy meals. Imagine all the parents burning down Chuck E. Cheese. Say I'm a psycho, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday things will be that way, and the world will be more fun. imagine all the actors and musicians too would stick to acting and singing with no political views. Imagine Barbara Streisand falling down a flight of stairs. You may say, I don't like Barbara Streisand. Looks like I'm not the only one. We had such a great time in North Carolina tonight. 'Cause you people here, you're so much fun. God bless you, everybody. Have a good night, yeah. Are you kidding me? So fun. Bless you guys. Thank you, Mark Stewart. Have a great rest of the year. Love ya.
I'm captivated, I say it, I'm on a whole new intrigue. My space invaded, upgraded, I hear you talking to me. It's in the boom of the thunder, it's in the cool of the rain. And I'll say, I don't ever wanna get away. Tonight is beautiful, it's got my mind on you. And everywhere I turn is a reminder. Soul's awakened, taken by all the beauty you bring.